As far as business of the bank is concerned, gross business of the bank has increased by 9.33% on YOY basis. Similarly, the gross deposit increased by 7% on year-to-year basis, and gross advance increased from the figure of 735,724 from September 2021 figure to 8,30,212 crore rupees with a growth rate of 12.84%. You may remember last time at the time of the guidance, I told you that credit growth we are targeting in the range of the 10% for the whole of the financial year. Since we have already achieved the 12.84% the YOY growth in the gross advances, so we are revising our credit growth guidance. It will be within the range of 12 to 13% because now there is a too much of demand from the credit from the market. Saving bank, there is a growth of the 5.84%, and CASA of the bank stood at 44.91% as against the 46.35% in the June quarter. Come to the operating part, there is a robust growth in the net interest income of the bank, 30.19% on YOY basis. In last September 2021 quarter, it was 6,353 crore rupees, which has improved to 8,271 with a growth rate 30.19%. Even if we compare with quarter to quarter, June to September, there is an increase of the 9.65%. Similarly, the operating profit, there is a growth of 38.4% of YOY basis. And if we compare quarter to quarter, it is a 3.5% growth. As far as net profit of the bank is concerned, if we compare quarter to quarter, there is an increase of around 33.44% because last quarter profit was 308 crore rupees, which has increased to 411 crore. But if you see year on year wise, definitely there is a dip in the around 62%. Come to the assets quality. Assets quality, which I am comparing only quarter to quarter, and I will give you the number of the last year also. 13.63% in the September 21, and which was reduced to 11.27% in the June 2022, further reduced to 10.48%. And similarly, amount has also reduced of the gross NPA, net NPA also. Net NPA, it was 5.49% in September 2021, 4.28% in the June last quarter, and further reduced to 3.8%. The last time we have given the guidance ki our gross NPA will be in the single digit by March 23, so we are maintaining that. Matlab, my purpose was telling to single digit, it may be 9.98% or the 9.90%, but since we have already achieved 10.48%, and you have seen every quarter there is a reduction of around 70 to 75 basis point. So although I am maintaining single digit, but it will be further reduced, maybe whatever it is coming in the single digit. Similarly, the net NPA guidance we have given, it will be in the range of 3.5 by March 23. This we are revising since we have already achieved 3.80 by the September quarter. So now we are confident, I am fully confident by March 23, this net NPA figure will be 3% or less than 3%. PCR has improved to 83.96%. And one more thing I want to tell you. Last time we have told ki we have made a target of the 32,000 crore of the total recovery in the full financial year. It means 8,000 crore rupees per quarter. And if you see the number of the both the quarter, first quarter mein, June mein, it was 7,057 crore rupees. And the second quarter, it is 8,564. This number which I am telling you, it is including the technical write-off as well as the part of the recovery booked in the recognized interest also. Because the in movement of the NPA, technical written off and the income which we have booked in the interest, that is not reflecting. And second point, I have told you ki our endeavor is like this ki our slippage should be less than the recovery number. So if you see the both the quarter, we have achieved that parameter also. In June 2022, total recovery was 7,057 crore rupees, whereas the addition was 6,400+, एंड इन द करेंट क्वार्टर मीन सितंबर क्वार्टर में रिकवरी वाज 8,564 करोड़ रुपीज, एंड द एडिशन वाज लेस देन 6,000 करोड़ रुपीज। तो वी हैव अचीव बोथ द नंबर की देर शुड बी 32,000 करोड़ रुपीज रिकवरी होनी चाहिए साल में, और सिमिलरली द एडिशन शुड बी लेस देन दी स्लिपेज। तो दिस इज अबाउट दी एसेट क्वालिटी। एज फार एज कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी, यू मे बी इंटरेस्टेड इन दी कैपिटल एडिक्वेसी रेशियो, एज ऑन डेट माई टायर वन इज 12.20% एज अगेंस्ट दी नॉर्मल 9.5%, एंड टोटल आर आर इज 14.74% एंड अगेंस्ट दी 12.50%। एज फर्दर रेजिंग ऑफ द कैपिटल, देर इज नो इमीडिएटली नीड ऑफ दी रेजिंग द कैपिटल, बट डेफिनेटली वी विल रेज द कैपिटल आइदर इन द करंट क्वार्टर और द नेक्स्ट क्वार्टर, सीइंग द मार्केट, व्हाट इज द मार्केट एक्सपेक्टेशन एंड व्हाट एवर द रेट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट। तो वी हैव ऑलरेडी गॉट द अप्रूवल फ्रॉम द बोर्ड फॉर द 12,000 करोड़ रुपीज, आउट ऑफ इज 5,581 एंड 6,500 करोड़ रुपीज इज द टायर टू। आउट ऑफ 5,500 वी हैव ऑलरेडी रेज 2,600+ करोड़ रुपीज इन दी लास्ट क्वार्टर, मतलब सितंबर क्वार्टर में। तो रिमेनिंग वी विल सी इफ द रेट एट विच वी वॉन्ट टू रेज द कैपिटल, डेफिनेटली वी विल नॉट माइंड रेजिंग द कैपिटल ऑल्सो पर्टिकुलरली 81, एंड इफ देर इज ए नीड ऑफ द टायर टू ऑल्सो, तो वी विल ऑल्सो रेज द टायर टू। एंड कमिंग टू द असेट्स क्वालिटी अगेन, रिकन्फर्म माई स्टेटमेंट विच आई हैव गिवन लास्ट क्वार्टर ऑल्सो, देर इज नॉट ए सिंगल बिग अकाउंट एज ऑन डेट इन माई किटी which we have to recognize. So we are working for the big account already recognized. We are doing resolution as well as the recovery. But definitely there was issue in the small account, RAM, that we are addressing. Even as on date, whatever the addition is the 5,900+ crore rupees in the September quarter, highest single account is only 178 crore rupees. And even for the SMA 2 figure, it was 10,287 crore rupees in the September 2022. As on date, it is further reduced to 4,363 crore rupees. And highest account in the 4,363 crore is only the less than 100 crore rupees, that is 94 crore rupees single account. So again, I am reconfirming, big account we are not thinking as on date to recognize in the times to come. And one more thing. When we are talking the assets quality, I told that there was an issue in the small account. We have worked on the both the account, underwriting standard as well as the collection efficiency. I am giving one very important data. From the we have made the analysis from the 1st July 2020 till date 30th September 2022, matlab more than 2 years. What type of credit acquisition we have made? So in that last two years. 2,70,812 crore rupees we have sanctioned, against which as on date outstanding is 1,90,756. Out of this NPA 1,90,756, hardly 945 crore, which is coming 0.35 crore rupees, 0.35%. And further, I am giving breakup because you may be interested. Ki further the was the segment agriculture only 2.25%. MSME, there is a little bit on higher side, 2.14%, retail 0.38%, others means corporate 0.02%. So it means it will give up the cushion ki which type of underwriting we are doing, and which I told you ki there was issue in the RAM. So I think one or two quarter mein everything will be cleared. So as far as NCLT account is concerned, as on date 560 account of 66,855 already admitted, and 62 account on the 4,869 is to be recognized. And NARCL mein we have already identified in first phase 9 account of 2,752 crore rupees. Out of 5 account mein we have got the offer from the consortium offer for the where the outstanding of the PNB is 1,099. Yes, fraud, as far as dispensation of the fraud is concerned, entire amount 651 was the pending in the last quarter, which was to be amortized in two quarters, half in the September quarter, half in the December quarter. But entire 6,051 we have already provided in this quarter itself. Nothing amount is pending for amortization in the times to come. So this is from my side. If you have any question also, I would like to answer your all the queries also. I may confirm the bank is on very right path. Bank is on the very right path. Whatever the future guidance we have given, I think we have achieved all the guidance which you have given to the last time. So bank is on the growth path. Ki only there is also 1 or 2 quarter, 23-24, whatever the number I have given, it's I think it should be a golden period for the Punjab National Bank. With this word, I am conclude my deliberation. Now floor is open for you. For Suraj, you can take off the chair.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. So anyone who wishes to ask any question, please request to press star raise hand button. Anyone who wishes to ask any question, request you to please press the raise hand button. We'll wait for a moment for the question queue to assemble. Yes, sir. So we have the first question from the chat window. It is from Harsh Agarwal. So the question is why we still have very high NPA from agriculture and MSME sector?
Yeah, I have already explained in my opening remarks also. There was definitely a legacy issue, and which we are addressing also. So, out of this 6,000 crore number, around 6,000 crore in this slippage, the agri was 2,785. And this is the not only in the Punjab National Bank. NPA in the agriculture is the issue of the banking industry. It is not only the issue of the Punjab National Bank, because some of the state, if the government has already announced the debt waiver also, the customer are not making the payment. This is the only reason I
अलाउ
want
कर
to
दिया
tell you.
बोलने के लिए उसको चैट ने भी लिखा चैट से ले लिया उसको अलाउ करो बोलने
But I have already given the data for the last 2 years for agriculture also. Total amount we have sanctioned agriculture में from the 1st of July 2022 30th September 2022 35,485 we have taken sanctioned fresh loan where NPA is only 89 crore which is coming 0.25% only.
Sir, the next question is from Neil Mehta. Neil Mehta requested to please unmute yourself and go ahead with your question. Neil, your voice is very feeble. Can you come closer to the mic and ask your question?
Yeah, am I audible now?
Yeah, you are audible now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Neil, go
Yeah,
ahead. Neil,
thanks.
go ahead. Now you are audible. Yeah.
Yeah, thank you, sir, for the opportunity. So we posted a profit, a treasury profit this year, this quarter of 102 crores, which was against a loss of 532 crores in the last quarter. Just wanted to understand what was the reason behind us posting a profit in a rising interest rate environment? Because our modified duration of the book, it actually rose back to 3.15 around. So if you can please explain what led to the profit on the treasury front.
Treasury profit, it was 160 crore rupees. Point number one. It is 160 crore rupees treasury profit, and mark to market, we have to provide 158 crore rupees. So, your specific question is the increasing interest rate, how the profit has come. some of the security was already purchased in the prior to increase of the rate of interest, which were in the profit we have sold. And this is profit is not only related to the G-Sec only. There is some profit also which is related to the trading in the equity also. So it is the combination of the sale of the equity, combination of the SLR and the non-SLR also, and sometimes there is a profit in the SR also. So it is a combination of all the things.
Okay, got it. So you're saying it's not just on account of the dealings in government securities. This could also have been on account of equity investments. Got it, sir. So, and if you could also give some color on what would be the guidance for the growth of the corporate book. Like it's currently, it was I think 14% YOY. So if you can just throw some color on how what do you what rate do you expect it to grow at?
If you see my credit growth, it is 12.84% in total. And if you see the composition of the 12.4%, it is 14.15% from the corporate sector. In addition to
Right.
the retail, it was around 16.95. If we go further for the retail mein, to vehicle mein, it was 35%. So our focus is on the RAM side. I am very honest to all of you. Our focus is on the RAM side. We want to increase the RAM portfolio because yield is much better as compared to the corporate book also. But we are also financing in the corporate also because corporate mein there is a good demand in some of the sector. Like there is a good demand in the road sector also. Infra there is a good demand also. And the government PLI scheme and the government is giving the thrust on the infrastructure in the other port etc. also there is also a demand. Even one more sector, NBFCs, is also there is a lot of demand. As on date, we are having the exposure of around 118,000 crore rupees in the NBFCs. And we have taken a good exposure in the good NBFCs. And I'm happy to share you out of 118,000 crore, 97% exposure to the NBFC, either A or AA or AAA externally rated. So we will do financing of all the sector, but RAM is the focus and corporate maybe if we are getting good proposal also, so we will not mind to go away the opportunity which is available as on date.
Got it, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. The next question is from Sanjeev Damani. Sanjeev Damani, please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question. Sanjeev, request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead with your question.
Hello. Yes. I think. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you're
Yeah.
audible
You
now.
are audible. Your picture is also, we can also see you also.
Thank you, sir. Sir, actually, just now you mentioned about 6,500 crores of rupees, which is amortized. So amortized means it is already written off from the P&L account. Should I take it this way?
Nahi, I am nahi, see. I think may I correct you? I have not told the figure of 6,500. I told you 651 crore rupees fraud. Fraud which was to
Okay.
be amortized in 2 quarter. Matlab 50% of
Okay.
the 651
Okay.
part we are to provide in September. So we have provided entire, nothing is the amount pending to be next quarter.
So it is written off from our P&L account. So to that extent, our profits are lower in this quarter.
It is coming under the head of the provision because as per RBI guidelines, if any account has been declared fraud, we can take the dispensation to make the provision in the 4 quarter. So
Okay.
651 crore rupees were outstanding, which has to be amortized in 2 quarter. 50% was to be provided in the September and 50 was provided to be December, but we have provided entire amount in this quarter. You are
So
right
it
ki
has
by this amount, profitability has been impacted.
impacted, and since it is a provision, this will carry on for next quarters. If it is recovered, then we can always take it back as profit.
Definitely, definitely. It is not an actual expenditure. I fully agree with you. It is not a actual expenditure. It is a provision. If we will make the recovery in the float account also, definitely there will be reversal of the provision. Fully agreed.
Thank you. The next question is from Mr. Anand Dama. Request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question.
Yes, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. Sir, first question was on in this quarter, RBI auditor basically had asked a lot of banks to make some standard asset provisions on the public sector entities. First, whether we have got any instruction like this, and if yes, what is the kind of provision that we have made? Is it the 170 crores that we have mentioned in the two accounts, or is it more to more on that?
Anand, actually, there is no communication. Let me clarify. Normally, this type of provision is being suggested. As on date, we have not received the report of the AFI, but we are aware some of the account, the other banks already made the provision, and we are also having the exposure in those account also. So we around 900 crore rupees, around 900 crore rupees, we have made a provision in the standard assets also, in this quarter also.
Okay, so is it pertaining to that instruction itself, or like is it on an ad hoc basis that we have done it?
No, I told you, na, Dama, I clarified you, ki there is no written instruction from the RBI to make the provision in this account, point number one. Point number two, regulator is taking the holistic view. If there is a weakness in some of the account, not in a particular bank, if there is weakness in the other bank also, so they are suggesting, I think it is a right approach also. So, as on date, because of our we have not received our FI also, but we have got the information that some of the bank, they were required to make the provision. So, we were also having the exposure. So, we have made it. It is not an ad hoc basis. It is an account specific.
Okay, so you believe that this is largely done with, right? So, and this is full. All the provision that we had to make, we already made it.
Around 800 to 900 crore rupees, we have made a provision in 3-4 account also. So definitely, if we receive the report also, if this account will already be there, so not required. If some other account will be there, so definitely we are required to make.
Okay, got it. So secondly was the outlook on the margins from here on. One is basically that you said that growth is going to be far better in the second half of the year, again, where you are basically focusing more on RAM, but even the corporate growth is going to come by. So what is the outlook on the margins in the second half of the year and going forward?
Anand, I may clarify you. I have not told ki we will not do the financing to the corporate. There is no question of the back also. But corporate, mein, suppose we are very cherry picking, triple A, double A also. So what yield we are getting? This is the reason I told you our focus on the RAM side, because we are getting the more yield as compared to the corporate. If you see my NIM also, in terms of the absolute number, already I have told you 30% growth is there. And I have told in the last call also, I have given guidance of the two number. I have never given the guidance for the net profit. I have given guidance for the two number. Ki operating profit, at least there will be a growth of the 10% to year on year basis. And similarly, I have given the guidance 10% growth in the NII also. But in particular quarter, there is a very good growth, 30% in the NII and 38% in the operating profit. It is only for the one quarter, and I am maintaining whatever the guidance I have given. NIM, last time we have given the guidance, ki it was 2.9%. I am talking about the domestic NIM. It was 2.90, which has improved to 3.11. So last time we have given the guidance that our NIM will be within the range of the 2.80 to 2.90. So today we are revising our guidance. We are giving the guidance that our NIM will be in the range of 2.9 to 3. So we are improving 10 basis point.
Okay, got it.
And so absolute number, I am again telling that quarter by quarter, our NII should be increased.
So third is about your staff cost. So for past two quarters, basically your staff cost was lower, and again it spiked up in the current quarter. So is it more of normalization of staff cost? Because earlier I believe we were carrying excess provisions.
No, Anand, it is only the one impact, because on account of the hardening of the interest, there was a reversal of the AS 15 provision in the earlier quarter, March quarter as well as the September quarter. But you may be remember last time what were the reversal of available. We have made the entire provision of the family pension. Total provision of the family pension was 394 crore rupees, and part we have provided in December and the March. So remaining we have provided in the June itself. So this is the impact of the only on account of the AS provision, nothing more. Otherwise,
So
there
this
is
is
no any increase in the salary cost, yeah.
so this run rate should continue going forward, is it?
Yeah. But definitely, I am very honest to all of you because November will be the time where the wage settlement is due for the next year. So definitely, we would like to make the provision, whatever the provision we have to make from the November itself for the wage revision.
And sir, any increase in the DA cost that you expect?
Any?
Increase in the DA cost, DNS allowance. So that also will have an impact next
नहीं वो
quarter.
तो डीए में तो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द इन्फ्लेशन दैट इज द इट इज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू प्रोड्यूस आल्सो व्हाट विल बी द इन्फ्लेशन है तो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द इन्फ्लेशन डीए भी देयर तो डेफिनेटली वी आल्सो
Sir, any ballpark figure as to what would be the impact on a quarter on quarter basis on the because of the wage settlement that you would try to build?
देखो अभी तो इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू से. नॉर्मली इफ यू सी द पास्ट ट्रेंड आल्सो, देखिए नवंबर 2020 से नेक्स्ट वेज रिवीजन इज डू. इफ यू सी द पास्ट ट्रेंड आल्सो द वेज रिवीजन वाज इन द रेंज ऑफ द 12 to 13% आल्सो. तो डेफिनेटली आई थिंक इट विल बी विद इन द सेम रेंज 10 to 12% आल्सो डेफिनेटली विल बी देयर.
Sure, sir. Thanks. Thanks.
Thanks. The next question is from the line of Priyans. Request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question.
Hello. Hello. Am I audible?
Yeah. Please, Priyans, you are audible. Please go ahead.
I think there is some technical difficulty from the line of Priyans. We'll go ahead with the next question. That is from the line of Mr. Bhavik Shah. Request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question. Bhavik also seems to be unresponsive. So we'll go ahead with Mr. Himanshu Taluja. Request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question.
Hi sir, thanks for the opportunity. Just few questions at my end. Firstly is on the our restructured pool of 14,000 OTR1 and OTR2. Can you just give a breakup? Where is this in the DPD buckets right now? They are part of standard SMA1, SMA2, and how much is already the part of the NPA?
Yeah. OTR1 as on date outstanding in the retail and the others 3,088 crore rupees, and MSME it is 479. If you make the total, OTR1 outstanding is 3,567. It is standard books. And you are also asking whatever the NPA also. So NPA in this 1,930 crore rupees in the OTR1. And this OTR2 outstanding as on date in the individual and small is 5,927, and MSME may it is 4,446. If you make the total, so 10,373, which is coming in the standard book, and NPA was around 1,850 crore rupees.
Okay.
1,900 plus 589 crore was the NPA in the individual and small, and 1,384 was in the MSME. Yeah.
Sir, what portion of your standard pool, standard restructured pool is out of the moratorium right now? And how much you expect overall, how much of this standard pool you expect to slip?
Abhi, I think 2 years is already over. Two years is because 2 years was the moratorium. 2 years has already been over as on date. So I think nothing is in the moratorium. Let me
Moratorium also.
yeah. But still, because some of the availment was the on the later side. So as on date, moratorium up to 30th September 2022 was around 3,558.
Okay. Fair. So of the remaining of 13,000 standard pool, out of this moratorium is 3,500. How much you expect to the restructure to slip basically in the coming quarters?
देखिए एज ऑन डेट वी आर नॉट ऑफ द व्यू कि एनी अकाउंट विल बी स्लिप्ड, बट कंसीडरिंग दी वट एवर द आउट ऑफ द टोटल रिस्ट्रक्चरिंग मेजर पोर्सन विच वॉज टू बी डाउन ग्रेडिड ऑलरेडी डाउन ग्रेडिड. तो वट एवर आई एम ट्राइंग टू टेल यू इन OTR 1 ओनली 1,221 इज द मोरिटोरियम एंड द OTR 2 इज अराउंड 2,329. तो एज ऑन डेट आई थिंक देर इज नो थ्रेट एज ऑन डेट बिकॉज सम ऑफ दी अकाउंट इवन दे आर नॉट कमिंग इन दी SMA 02 बुक ऑल्सो. तो आई एम क्वाइट ऑप्टिमिस्टिक वट एवर अकाउंट टू बी डाउन ग्रेडेड ऑलरेडी डाउन ग्रेडेड बिकॉज यू सी विच नंबर विच यू हैव ऑलरेडी अराउंड 1,607 और 324 इफ यू मेक द टोटल 1,925 ऑलरेडी डाउन ग्रेडेड. सी एनी फर्दर लिफ्ट विद दैट इफ होती पे तो नॉमिनल अमाउंट विल बी देयर.
ओके श्योर सर. सेकंड इज यू हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन सिंस देयर इज नो बिग अकाउंट्स व्हिच आर अंडर स्ट्रेस एंड यू हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन द एसएमए 2 अबव 5 करोर्स. सिंस द पेन इज इन द लोअर एंड ऑफ द अकाउंट्स कैन आई गेट द नंबर ऑफ द एसएमए 1 एंड एसएमए 2 व्हिच इज बिलो 5 करोड़.
नहीं आई मे करेक्ट यू ऑल्सो द नंबर ये इन प्रेजेंटेशन दे हैव गिवन 5 करोड़ एंड अबोव बट आई एम गिविंग यू टोटल नंबर. वट एवर द नंबर आई हैव रिपीटेड इन माई कन्वर्सेशन 10,287 वॉज द नंबर ऑफ द SMA 2. इट इज एंटायर 10,287 इज नॉट मोर देन 5 करोड़. इट इज एंटायर SMA 2 नंबर बैंक एज ए होल विच हैज रिड्यूस टू 4,363. एंड इफ यू वॉन्ट टू SMA 01 टू नंबर ऑल्सो एज ऑन डेट आई एम गिविंग द लेटेस्ट नंबर SMA 0 16,183 एंड वन इज SMA 1 इज द 9,553. टोटल टोटल SMA 01 2 एज ऑन डेट इज अराउंड 30,000 ओनली. देर इज नो क्वेश्चन ऑफ दी 5 करोड़ एंड अबाउट द लेस देन 5 करोड़. दिस इज द इवन 1 रुपीज अकाउंट दैट इज SMA 01 2.
ओके सर. नाउ फाइनली अल्टीमेटली आर फेस ऑफ द रिकवरी इज हेल्दी बट व्हाई व्हेन यू एक्सपेक्ट द स्लिपेजेस बिकॉज़ वी आर स्टिल ऑन द ग्रॉस स्लिपेजेस वी आर ऑन अ एलिवेटेड साइड. सो व्हाई व्हेन यू एक्सपेक्ट द स्लिपेजेस टू नॉर्मलाइज
Himanshu, I
ऑन द
think
प्रोविजनिंग फ्रंट एज वेल.
I Himanshu, I think I have given you the answer of your question in my conversation also. देखिए what was the issue? Issue was if there is a stress in the RAM sector also, there was a major issue कि what type of fresh underwriting we are doing. तो we have worked on both the sector, both the first the underwriting standard. Another is the collection efficiencies. I have given you the data of the last 2 years sanction also. And I have told you कि slip वहाँ पे NPA slippage is only 0.35%. तो whatever your specific query कि ये कब खत्म होगा, तो I think only by March 23, maybe one or two quarter. तो whatever the legacy issue of the RAM is there, it will be completely wiped out. And 23-24, as I told you earlier also, will be the golden period. No slippage, no, only the recovery will come.
Okay, sure, sir. Thanks. That's it from my end.
And you see the GST collection also, na? GST collection has improved 1.40 lakh crore also. This is also giving one of the signal key. There is a economic growth on the right track, consecutive from the last 8 months.
Yeah, sure, sir. Thanks.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Maru. Request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question.
Yeah, hello, sir. Good evening. So, my first question is, can you please tell me the ECLGS slippages? ECLGS slippage? And if you could
Okay, okay.
please repeat the
Easy.
SMA numbers? Yeah.
Yeah. ECGS, Baru, around 21,460 crore we have sanctioned. Out of which 12,868 crore rupees is the outstanding, and out of which NPA as on date is 840 crore rupees, which is coming around 6.53%.
Hello. Okay, sir. Thank
Yeah,
you. Can you
Bharu.
please remove the
Yeah, yeah.
SMA numbers, please? Yes.
SMA number देखिए SMA 2 was 10,287 from the 0 rupees. It is not a 1 crore above, 2 crore above. 10,287 was the entire SMA 2 in the bank as a whole in the September 2022, which has drastically reduced to 4,363. If you want to ask the number of the total SMA 0 one also, it is 30,000. And 16,183 for the SMA 0, then SMA 1 is 9,553,
4,363 SMA 2. Thank you. Okay, we go ahead with the next question, which is from the line of Mr. Bhavik Shah. Bhavik, request you to please unmute yourself.
Hi, sir. So thanks for the opportunity. So I have two questions. So first is, so what is your current liquidity coverage ratio?
Current?
Liquidity
Bhavik,
coverage
can you repeat
ratio.
Question? Achha, liquidity coverage ratio. It is 160. It remains between the 150 to 160 as against the requirement of the 100%. So it is 150 to 160% because we are having so many excess SLR. 50,000 crore rupees excess SLR we are sitting as on date.
Okay. So thanks for that. And sir, one more thing. So what would be the outstanding deferred tax asset and when do we plan to consider shifting to the new tax regime?
As on date, because we are already having the accumulated loss in our book, so we have taken the opinion of our consultant also. I think as on date, we are not getting any benefit to shift the new tax regime, and we have given the disclosure in our note to accounts also. So as on date, there is no plan. So we will take appropriate decision when we will of the view that definitely it is the right time to shift from the old regime to new regime.
Okay, and sir, we saw a couple of banks getting divergence report from RBI. Is our divergence done? As in, is it reportable material?
As on date, we have not received our report.
Okay. Thank you, sir. So that's
thank
it from
you,
my
Bhavik. Thank you, Bhavik.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Mr. Priyans. Request you to please unmute yourself.
Yeah. Sir, my first question is that with respect to our CASA growth, our current account deposit growth has been very, very minor. You can see that as of September 21, we had current account deposit of 71,958 crore, whereas as of September 22, it's only 7,741 crore, hardly 1% growth. And you know, current account deposit is like, you know, free money, no interest has to be paid. So I would like to understand and I would like to give you a constructive feedback that the board must give a concrete target to all the CGM and GM and the branch managers to incorporate and to introduce additional number of corporate accounts wherein we can get current account.
Yes, we are aware whatever you are saying, it is a really concern area for us also. As you have told, there is a very nominal growth. We are aware of that. It is 1.09%. But if you compare from the June also, June said there is a good growth. It was 69,332 crore rupees, which has increased to 72,740 crore, around 3,000 crore rupees. What we have done, we are targeting the corporate client where we can open the savings bank account also, and some of the large corporate, if they are having some other associate also, so we are targeting those also, and we have also provided the tab to our all 10,000 branches. after providing the TAP, there is a lot of improvement in opening of the account. Time has reduced, that has been reduced, but that is being done on the saving bank account as on date. We are shifting for the saving bank to the current account. So time will come definitely. Current account mobilization will also be approved, but I fully agree. Whatever your concern have shown, we are fully agile of it.
So appreciate your positive feedback. I am only requesting that you being the like chief of the bank, from the board level, some solid guideline and instruction must be passed on to all the executive management of the bank to mobilize additional number of corporate account and also salary account. So you know that, so that we can have this, you know, like, you know, this when the funnel will be bigger, automatically what your money will pass through. Bank will make some money out of this. So I think this is one of the niche area to be tapped into with a constructive implementation strategy.
No, you are right, Priyansh. We have already, part of the advice has already been done. We have already instructed to our all the zonal head who are in the state capital, because current account normally we can garner big account in the state capital. Also, this instruction has already been to the zonal heads. In the state capital, they should garner the more and more current deposit account in the regular operation.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Mr. Sunil Mehta. Request you to please unmute.
Yeah, this is not Sunil Mehta. He is my colleague. I am Ashok Ajmera. Good evening, sir. I met you in the morning also.
Good afternoon. Good evening, Ajmera ji. Good afternoon. Yeah, please.
Yeah, I was waiting for a long time. Most of the queries have been answered, but I just need to ask a few questions and some observations. Now you see, with the interest rate hardening up and inflation going up, we feel that even in the RAM book, there can be some pressure. So though your SMA 2 is 10,287 crore, going forward, especially in this quarter, September-December quarter, do you see some pressure coming in SMA 2 book, if not the NPA finally?
Nee, dekhiye, as on date, there is no much pressure also, because Ajmera ji, I have given two data also. 10,287 figure which I have given to you, that is outstanding of the SMA 2 as on 30th September. But we have taken the data of the current data also. So it has reduced 4,363. So it means there is not a pressure, there is reducing. Because all our machinery in the field, we are having 10,000 branches. Main focus of the bank is on the recovery, because profit has to come from the recovery. And the 90,000 crore rupees, it has reduced to 87,000 crore is the recovery, the gross NPA number. And in addition to that, 87,000 is the technical write-off. So each and every employee of the bank is for the recovery. When they are making the recovery of the NPA, they are also making the effort to recovery in the standard account. But definitely, whatever your specific question, because interest rate is started harden and the MCLR has already been changed, even the RLR has also been changed, because as per the RBI guidelines, all the retail and the MSE loan has to be linked with the external benchmark. When external benchmark has already been increased, so naturally there will be an increase in the EMI, or the they have to make the more payment. But as on date, we have kept our watch open for this also, and we are very we are seeing ki how to address this. As on date, we are not seeing any pressure.
Okay, sir. Now, sir, in case of this NARCL, you said the 9 account of 2,752 crores have been considered now, and out of that 5, you have got already the offer from NARCL for 1,099 crore. So this is our portion in the consortium, or the total consortium amount?
I have earlier clarified also, out of the 9 account, 5 account mein we have got the offer from the NARCL. 1,999 is the outstanding. It is not the amount also. It is a outstanding in my books.
Yeah.
Because in some of the account, the other bank is the leader of the consortium. So it is only my outstanding, my share. 1,099 is the my outstanding.
So you expect approximately realization of about 20-25%, because in one account we see only 5%. In another account, we are seeing about 35%. So in this FI account, you must have by now calculated that how much percentage of it, especially with NARCL, we are getting. Forget about the cash recovery and the SRs, but what is the total recovery you expect from this FI account, sir?
Yeah, Ajmera ji, it will be finalized only after the completion of the processes. I may tell you, in one account, we were the leader of the consortium.
Yes, sir.
And we have got the, it is in the newspaper also, where we have got the offer from the NARCL around 238 crore rupees. So, I can take the percentage, what is my share also. But we have, we have gone to the Swiss challenge method, so we have got around more than 400 crore rupees. So, it is very difficult to say what will be the actual recovery. It is under process. So, final outcome will be in a position, we will be in a position to see what will be the actual recovery.
Okay, sir. My next question is, sir, on the treasury front, how are we placed? So far you have managed it well. But going forward, if we expect about 50 to 60 basis point still rise in the interest rate, depending on the Fed rate today, late night coming in. So how much we are cushioned for any treasury mark-to-market losses and also the trading income point of view?
Dekhe, my treasury is very active. My treasury is very active and they were making very good profit also. But on account of the increase in the interest rate, this is the function of the interest rate, not the function of the treasury person also. So as on date, whatever the requirement of the mark-to-market provision, we have already provided in the June and September also. So we are immunized. So whatever you are saying, if there is a further increase in the rate of interest also, so naturally we have to make the provision, additional provision we were required to make also. But if you say it is keeping on the changing also, why I am saying keeping on changing, that if you see the 10-year G-Sec, it was 7.45 in the June 2022. And in between also, it has reduced to 7.19 also. So treasury, it is a function of the treasury. They must have taken any provision also to make the profit also. But as on date, we are immunized, we have provided. But definitely, if there will be a further increase in the rate of interest, so we have to make the provision also. Yeah.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Aslesh Sonje. Requested to please unmute and go ahead with your question.
Hi sir, just one question from my side. Can you explain what is driving the 27% QOQ increase in staff expenses this quarter?
Aslesh, your voice was breaking. Can you repeat your question? Aslesh, can you repeat your question? Your voice was breaking.
Sir, I think the question was, what is the reason behind sharp increase in the staff cost on a QOQ basis?
Oh, okay. Already I have explained to the Anand ko na. There is not an increase. Dekhiye, last quarter, on account of the increase in the interest rate, AS provision in the June quarter as well in the March quarter, there was a reversal. But in this particular quarter, there was some provision also. That was the only reason, because interest rate, if you compare from the June to September, it has reduced, because it was 7.5 in the June quarter and 7.45. So there was a difference of the 5-6 basis point. On account of this, we have to make the provision for the AS15. Otherwise, my employee cost is flat. That is, in whatever increase you are seeing, that is on account of the AS15, because last time there was a reversal. And whatever the reversal was there, we have not utilized. We have made the entire provision of the family pension, which was supposed to in the 3-4 years.
Thank you. The next question is from line of Ronak. Requested to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question.
Hello, am I audible?
Yeah. Yes, Ronak ji, please.
So, sir, good evening. I wanted to ask, what is the segment-wise slippages breakup for the quarter?
Yeah, segment-wise slippage, the bifurcation of the 5,978 is 2,785 in the agriculture. MSME, there is a 1,597. Retail, 623. And others, 296. and remaining 3,378 is in the existing account. So it is coming 5,979.
Okay, thank you, sir. And one more question was, what is the guidance on advances and deposit growth?
Advances growth, last time we have given the target of around 10% because we have already achieved 12.84%. So we are revising our guidance. Current year there will be a 12 to 13%, but deposit, I think there is no need any guidance. Also deposit is the function of the how much you require, whatever the increment growth is there. So either we can raise the fund, if the fund is not available at the cheaper rate, we will also try to redeem some of the SLR if we are in a position considering the movement in the interest rate. Otherwise, need based, we will raise the deposit from the market.
Okay, and what will be the cost income ratio and slippages and the credit cost for the next quarter?
Credit cost, if you see, it was reduced to last quarter, it was 2.46%. Reduced to the 1.76%. So we are giving the guidance, it will be around 2% for whole of the year. As far as cost to income, I think it will remain in the same whatever it is on date. There is no much difference. As I told you, we have to provide for the wage revision also. The little bit there may be an increase also. But we are trying to increase the NII and also the other income. So whatever the ratio should not be impacted.
Okay, thank you, sir. Yeah, that's it from my side.
Thank you. The next question is from the chat window. So the question is, sir, on the loan book breakup by benchmark that you present on the presentation, the share of FCI and other currencies loans, other bench variable rate loans are seems very high at around 27%, while your overseas book seems to be only 5% of the overall loans. So can you give some color that why the share of FCI and
I can give you the breakup of this also. Actually 26% we have given the which is in the foreign currency and the others. The major portion of this in the this which is apart from the RLLR or the MCLR, the maximum portion is coming in this particular bucket is the TBLR. So all of the loan which I have given this 26.48%, it is basically on the floating side also. So I can give you the further breakup of this TBLR 9.07%. Elite is 12.43. Elite is the another category of the repo link rate, and the foreign currency is the 4.98%. It is floating. I am confirming it is floating. Your worry will be whether it is a floating or fixed. As on date, my fixed rate is only 7 to 8% only.
Okay. And a related question to that is regarding the overseas book growth. So that book has, you know, saw a healthy growth this quarter. The question is, if you can just give us some color on the from where the growth is coming. Is it local credit or buyer's credit or, you know, Indian linked to Indian corporates or any other refinancing or, I mean, what it is?
Major portion is from the bank to the bank also. Major portion in this is the exposure to the bank.
Bank as in, sir, I mean, is it related to Indian corporates or buyer's credit or?
India, some portion to the Indian corporate also is there, but major portion is the total exposure in the loan to the banks, where we are getting some spread.
Okay, understood, sir. Understood. Okay, the next question is from the line of Mr. Satish. Requested to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question. Satish, request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question.
Sir, Hindi mein puchta hoon. Ye quarter mein dividend dene wale hai kya?
Please, Satish ji, please go ahead.
Hello.
सतीश जी प्लीज गो अहेड, सतीश जी
हाँ
बताइए
सर,
बताइए सतीश जी, हिंदी में पूछिए कोई दिक्कत नहीं, हिंदी
ये
में पूछिए।
क्वार्टर में डिविडेंड मिलने वाला है क्या?
क्वार्टर में, आप क्वार्टर कह रहे हैं या फाइनेंशियल ईयर? क्वार्टर में कोई ऐसा डिविडेंड का नहीं है अभी क्वार्टर में।
Thanks. The next question is from the line of Mr. Priyans. Request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead with the question.
Yes, sir. Sir, like in the February 22, Mr. Tushar Mehta, Solicitor General, has submitted to Honorable Supreme Court that 18,000 crore rupees have been recovered from the three defaulter, big defaulter, Nirav Modi, Choksi, and Vijay Mallya. So, sir, how much is the share of PNB, proportionate share of out of that recovery, and when that money is going to come to our bank?
We are trying in the process of the recovery also, so it will take some time. We are taking because some of the amount has been which have been taken by the enforcement act, some has been given to the government, some has been released to us also. So we are taking up the matter. It will take some time, but I think around maybe 800 to 1,000 crore. I think we can get the money in another 6 to 9 months. That is our estimation.
Hi sir, a few questions sir from my side. Sir, you mentioned this SMA 2 number which has come down from 10,000 to 4,600 crores. This is from September to as on date, right? 1-2 days before, right? So sir, this 30,000 crore is actually corresponding to this 4,600 crores of SMA 2, right? On that basis. If you can share the SMA 012 number as of September number, sir, so that would have more quarter to
No,
quarter.
it is not 40, it was 91,000 plus in this number. It was
91.
91,000 plus number because SMA zero is on account if there is a 1 day. 71,614 was the number, which has reduced to 16,183. I may tell you, it is not a, sometime it is not a actual SMA zero. Please try to understand. I am trying to explain. That is a accounting issue also. Suppose we have given some loan, we are working on that. We are trying to address that issue also. Suppose we have given housing loan, their installment is due on the 2nd of the month or the 3rd of the month or the 4th of the month. So whatever as on date, suppose we are debiting the interest on the last day of the month. So system is generating the demand of the interest, where it is included in the EMI. So very next day it is coming in the SMA zero, but moment we are receiving the EMI installment, so it is brought down immediately. So we are trying to change the system also. So it is a accounting issue. Sometime on account of the 0 day default, it is not an actual SMA, but it is coming.
Understood, sir. So understood. And secondly, sir, is there any NPA recovery that goes to interest income in this quarter or in general also? That, you know, if there is an NPA recovery, how do we apportion that towards principal
Yeah,
interest and fee?
definitely. देखिए, I told you 8,564 crore my was the total recovery. And if you see the my movement of account, total cash recovery and upgradation is 6,497. It means 1,705 has come either in the recovery in the return of account and either in the recovery in the interest. So I have the number of the recovery in the return of account is the 1,053. If you reduce 1,053 from the 1,705, remaining is in the interest income.
Understood. Very well explained, sir. So the principal or the order would be NII fee and then lastly in the provisions, right? Is that the way to understand? Because that is what most of the banks involve.
It is our as per the board policy. It is our
Sure,
the
sure.
board policy. This I can tell you. Yeah.
Sure, sir. And last thing, sir, because you have would have seen a lot of question on staff cost. It would be easy, sir, if you can bifurcate either now or maybe from next quarter onwards the proportion into cash salary and AS 15 provisions, so that you know, so that there is a more clarity that you know.
I may tell you the figure. This particular quarter, around 300 crore rupees was the AS 15 provision. The remaining was the cash basis. Yeah. Whereas there was a reversal in the last quarter, because I told you last quarter, because there is a gap of the 5-6 basis point in the G-Sec yield. September may it has reduced as compared to the June.
Right, understood, sir. Yeah, that is very well explained, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Mr. Babik. Request you to please unmute yourself and go ahead.
What is the reason for hi sir, taking this question further. Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, Bhavi, please go ahead.
Yeah, taking this question further, so the recovery which is apportioned to NII, sir, what was the amount last quarter? I understand this quarter it was 650 crores.
650 crore, it was on the same range, hardly difference of the 1500 crore rupees. So the, you cannot see ki NII has increased only on account of discount. It is on the same. There is a hardly difference of the 50 or 75 crore rupees.
Sir, will this sustain over the coming quarters? I guess this will be a function of recovery, right? The traction of recovery, or how do we look at it?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely recovery is in the 7,057, 8,500 pillars, and we have the target of the 32,000 whole of the year. So this will remain same also. And sir, even in the sum of the account which is substandard also, if they will be upgraded also, so entire money which is overdue, it will come to the interest income only.
So next year, what would be the recovery target then?
I think first we should be in a position to complete 32,000 crore rupees, then we will set a target for next year also. But next year I told you, because slippage will be very less, recovery will be the only focus area. So that will be the golden period for the Punjab National Bank.
Okay. And sir, last question from my side. Sir, for example, if repo hike happens today, the reset is on T plus one basis, or it happens after a quarter?
No, same. Very next day.
Okay.
Next day.
Okay. Thanks a lot, sir. That's it from my
thank
side.
You, thank you.
Good luck.
Thank you, Bhavi. Thank you, Bhavi. Yeah.
Thank you. The next question is from the line of Mr. Daga. Request you to please unmute.
Yeah, sir. Thanks for taking my question again. So, wanted to ask what is the reason for decline in core fee income quarter on quarter?
Fee-based income quarter to quarter, if you see, there is on account of the some exchange income also, some of the processing fees also. Normally, the processing fees we are mostly recovering in the first quarter. That is the major reason. Otherwise, not. And if you see the year to year also, that September 2021, it was 1,162 and it has improved to 1,307. Year to year, it is increased, but quarter is on account of some policy, accounting policies also.
Okay, thank you, sir. And another question was that why is there a depreciation on investment in the second quarter despite some moderation in 10-year yields quarter on quarter?
No, that was two type of provision. One is the 551 crore rupees was in the provision side on account of the NPI, that is not in the mark to market. So whatever the provision is there, which you are saying, that is we have taken some position also. We have taken some position because I told you, please remember my sentence also, the 7.50 was the yield in the June, and in between 7.19 was also the it has gone to 7.19. maybe some position must have been taken, so this was the reason of that also.
Okay, yeah, thank you, sir. That was my questions and all the best. Thank you.
Thank you. Couple of questions from the chat window. Question number was, sir, last quarter you mentioned some 25 billion of restructuring for the earlier restructured scheme, which is this CDR, SDR, 525, and etc. So if you can just provide the number for same number for the corresponding this quarter.
The number the restructuring now CDR etc. is not as on date. All the account of the CDR, SDR has already been turned to the NPA also. So the as on date only the OTR 1 and OTR number is relevant. We have already given as on date. So CDR, SDR, I think we don't have any outstanding as on date.
Okay, understood. One more question from the chat window is, sir, relating to the food credit. So if the food, I mean, if we see that RBI data of the food credit growth, that growth is, you know, coming down for the last couple of months. And related to that is that one of the larger, you know, government, semi-government kind of account has, you know, larger exposure. You have something around 14,000, 15,000 crore related to food credit of India. So if you can just provide us, you know, the what would be the total exposure of Punjab National Bank to FCI, and are there any concern in that particular account?
I may tell you one more thing also, particularly. There is a two type of the food credit. Like you have raised the specific question for the FCI. FCI may some part is coming under the food credit, some part they are after raising from the market, which is not food credit. I may tell you, we were having the very good exposure on the FCI before September, but as on date September, apart from the food credit, we are having the nil exposure. Whatever food credit that is there, but apart from the food credit, it has become paid by them.
Okay. And sir, how would the, you know, exposure to FCI would be divided amongst, you know, many lead bankers, like including you and other, you know, PSU banks?
That is based on the data. Every year they decide how much share based on your total exposure to the balance sheet size basis. That is on the based on the balance size of the each and every bank. So on the basis of the assets of the particular bank, it is being divided. Yeah. On the same proportion.
Okay, understood. And one last question from the chat window is, what is the strategy for gold loan business? What is the target for gold loan business going ahead?
Gold loan, if you see the gold loan as compared to other bank, our portfolio was very less. We have revamped our gold loan scheme, which is at par with the industry also. And we have given a good target around 4,000, 5,000 crore rupees for the bank as a whole for this current financial year.
Okay, understood. And I think that was all. I mean, that was the last question from the investor side. So I think we can now close this question and answer session. Hand over the mic to MD sir for your closing remarks.
Thank you very much, Suraj ji. Very live interaction with all the analysts also. And whatever their worry and the question also, we were in a position to reply all the question also. So we have noticed some of the suggestion also. One or two things, there was a good suggestion also. So we will try to implement those suggestions for the betterment of the country. So I may tell only the bank on the right path. Bank is on the right. Why I'm telling, why the bank on the right path? Operating profit is increasing, net interest income is increasing, recovery is increasing, slippage is declining as compared to the recovery number, gross NPA is reducing, net NPA is reducing, and PCR is reducing. Only concern, which you may be aware also, only the net profit also. So because we are addressing the earlier issues also, RAM, because there was a lot of delinquency in the RAM, so time will come in the after one or two quarter, I think we will be in a position to so the decent net profit also. So this is my assurance to all the investor also. Nothing more I want to do, and I want to come and I thank you to all the person who have joined this meeting of the analyst meet. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.